Hey everybody, Spider here, the Coming Soon Podcast. Of course, coming to you once again here in San Antonio, Texas. We are inside the Wonderland of the American Mall. Duncan Regehr, how are you doing today, sir?
Very well. Pleasure to meet you.
No, likewise. Of course, I was with you yesterday. I happened to catch you guys at lunchtime, so I couldn't get my interview yesterday, but I do appreciate your time. Now, of course, here in San Antonio, is this your first time in the city?
Second time in the city. Now, a few years ago at another con.
You see, and I forgot to bring this up, but because of the whole vampire movie, you and I might come out on video. We'll see. I don't know. We'll see how that works.
Yeah.
But, of course, playing that character, of course. I mean, back in the day, I mean, it became a classic. A lot of people still refer to it. Now, you've done other work besides that, but has this always been, like, one of your go-tos?
Well, it's been a favorite role to play, for sure. I mean, it's an iconic character throughout film history and in literature as well. So, played by some wonderful actors down through the years.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, it's a strong legacy, and, very honored to play it.
Now, let me ask you, well, when it came to playing Dracula, of course, I mean, did you kind of study or did you kind of watch other film just to see which way you were going to go with it?
Yeah, a little bit. I really wanted to make it quite different. I had to, you know, sort of incorporate the classic aspects that were,
right,
premiered with Bela Lugosi and, and the like, you know, several people. So you had that costume aspect, you know, indicated sort of nobility to the character.
Right.
But I wanted to, you know, at the time we were filming it, create more of a sociopathic individual that really knew what he wanted.
Yeah.
And he was vicious.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely vicious and psychotic. And there wasn't any sort of romantic aspect to
right.
him in any way. He wasn't a lover boy or anything like that.
Right,
he was
right.
Not for anybody.
Now, let me ask you, because of the monsters that were portrayed, of course, if you had to pick, if you had to go back, would you have picked another monster?
No.
Nice.
Because, you know, the interesting thing about Dracula is that he is the greatest monster.
Yeah.
Because he incorporates human aspects to him. And human beings, their dangerous dark side is pretty much the most monstrous that you can find.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I agree. You know, it's like I tell people, a lot of times, for me, when it comes to a character, I like knowing that it's a person because it kind of makes it a little bit more relatable.
Yeah.
I mean, Dracula, like you said, that's kind of...
It's a slathering kind of monster that bites people. You know?
Yeah.
But it doesn't really have much of an agenda. It needs something.
Yeah. No, for sure. And of course, I mean, being that this is the second time here in San Antonio, have you ever been out here on vacation? I mean, have you been able to see the city?
A little bit of the city, the river walk, the Alamo, and the walk around,
And that's all we got anyway, so that's it. No.
There's an art museum that I missed out on twice now, but next time I'm here, I'll get
it. No, I mean, definitely. I mean, right now, it's a little too hot. I mean, even for Dracula, you know, it's a little too hot out there. But of course, you know, fall is coming. I mean, it's a beautiful time. The city's growing. It's, I was born and raised here, so I got nothing but good things to say. But if you guys come back, for sure, man. I mean, definitely, there's a lot more to see than downtown, you know. But
I'm sure.
And let me ask you now, because of things like this, I mean, when it comes to conventions, do you enjoy this? Is this kind of like your, hey, you know what, let me give back and stay in the mix kind of thing?
Well, I just really like to meet the people. I enjoy that, you know, especially the families, you know, you have the situation where the grandparents have seen the movie, they bring their children, and they bring their children.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a family thing, and it's nice to engage with people.
No, for sure. You see, one of the things, I have two kids, right? My daughter and my son, and I raised them in the 80s. You know, I raised them in movies. I mean, their terminology, I'll say it this way. My youngest, when she was in high school, I mean, in elementary school, this is years back, she comes home and she's like, "Dad, you know, my friends don't think I'm funny." You know, and I was like, "Kid, you're the most funniest person I know." And I said, "You know what? You have an 80s sense of humor." I said, "They don't get you because you're in another era, you know." And she kind of thought about it, and she was like, "Yeah, you're right, Dad, you know, because, like at home, I always tell people, we speak three languages, Spanish, English, and movie quotes. So if they don't get my movie quotes, then we can't talk, man." But of course, I mean, when it comes to family, how's everything going for you guys?
Well, for me, it's great. I mean, my family in Canada, my son is grown.
Oh, yeah. And of course, I mean, going back home, I mean, does he bring movies like this up? Does he bring up movies like this?
He knows everything I've done. Absolutely. Better than I do.
There you go. He reminds you, right? He's like, hey, remember when you did this? Or like, and of course, is he in film? I mean, is he actually pursuing anything himself?
No, he's in the computers and I guess, making portfolios and money.
Oh, okay.
He's a rich guy.
Oh, okay. So he doesn't have to work, right? And let me ask you, before you actually got into acting, I mean, what was it that you were pursuing yourself? Was it always acting?
I pretty much knew what I wanted to do by the time I was 12, but I was an artist from the beginning, and I still am.
Acting
was sort of a tangent of the main course, painting.
No, and you see, and being an artist, because of course being an actor is the same, I mean, when it comes to art, drawing, singing, I mean, anything creative, I mean, it is an artistic art form. Did that kind of help you get into, like, with your characters? I mean, being able to express yourself like that?
A little bit, I suppose. You know, I've used it to sort of develop certain things about a character sometimes.
Right.
You know, when I played Zorro, you know, and I come up with some sketches. You know, as I'm thinking about how I want to create this big character. Same with Dracula.
Parts
I've made, but not all.
No.
They really are two separate mediums. Painting is quite different. It's a solo sort of endeavor. And acting is very much collaborative. You've got to work with everyone. And the final product is as a result of what that collaboration is.
You see, and one of the things when it comes to acting, a lot of times you hear about characters like, oh, so-and-so was supposed to play this movie or this part.
Right.
But I don't think anybody would have played that more perfect than yourself. I mean, I think that role was definitely for you. And I know that's probably your best Dracula out there, but is there a second that you kind of look back and you're like, hey, that guy did a good job portraying Count Dracula?
Well, somebody else that played it?
Yeah,
I like Gary Oldman's Dracula very much. He's a culprit.
Oh, okay, cool, man. Yeah, you say enough. Of course, I mean, I know you try to put your own twist on this. Before this opportunity, were you a fan of horror?
Pardon me?
Were you a fan of horror? Were you already kind of like, when this movie came out, were you kind of like already into horror?
Not really, no. No, I have to say no. I was into the theater.
And what did you think? I mean, what was going on when you were like, Count Dracula, like, I can do this, or?
No, they just, you know, they called me up and you'd like to read for it, and I said, sure. And it was a long audition process for this film. And, you know, lots of competition. In the end, they decided to go for what I was offering.
No, well, that's cool, man. I mean, of course, I grew up watching these movies just like everybody else. They're always my go-to when you know, I'm home and the family and the kids come over. It's like, man, we definitely throw it on. So we see you just about every week, man. So this is the first time seeing you in person. Definitely great. I do thank you for the opportunity, my man. I wish you the best with everything that's coming, especially your art, and I hope we keep seeing more of it.
I've got a show coming up in November in Vancouver.
Oh, okay.
I have an art exhibit at the Pepe Jones Gallery.
Yeah, I wish I could say I could make it. I probably won't be out there in Canada,
maybe,
but
somebody will make it.
No, for sure, of course.
Go to DuncanRegehr.com. Check
out. No, I definitely will put that link on there, and I'll let people know where to follow you. Because one of the things that I like to do is, not that you guys need it, but I mean, just people know where you guys are headed or see what you guys are up to, man. So I do thank you, man. Thank you for the opportunity. Everybody out there, of course, once again, this is Spider, the Coming Soon Podcast. Till next time, follow up.